It was especially the fashion to frighten the new boys, the little ones as they were called, who on their arrival would hear so many weird stories about the castle as to make them superstitious and timid to the extreme. They were most afraid of a certain room at the end of a corridor that had served as bedroom to the Emperor Paul, where he had gone to bed one night quite well and had been carried out dead next morning. The old boys maintained that the spirit of the Emperor haunted that room and came out every night to inspect his beloved castle, and the little ones believed it. The room was always securely fastened with several locks, but to a spirit, no lock or bar is of significance. Besides, it was said that it was possible to get into the room, and this turned out to be true. At any rate, a few of the older cadets managed to get in, and continued to do so until one of them committed an outrageous piece of mischief for which he had to pay dearly. He found a way of getting into that terrible bedroom and managed to hide a sheet there. At night he went there, covered himself from head to foot in the sheet, and stood by the dark window that looked out into the street, where he could be seen by anyone passing by. In playing the part of a ghost, the cadet certainly managed to bring terror upon many superstitious people who lived in the castle or who happened to pass by and see the white figure, all taking it from the shade of the late emperor. This piece of mischief continued for several months and caused a persistent rumor that the Emperor Paul walked about in his bedroom at night and looked out on St. Petersburg from this window. Many were certain that the white ghost at the window shook his head and bowed to them more than once. The cadet, of course, was capable of doing these things. All this caused general discussion and prophetic explanations, and ended with the culprit who had caused this anxiety being caught red-handed. He received exemplary punishment and disappeared forever from the institution. There was a rumor that at one of his appearances at the window, the cadet had the misfortune to frighten some important person who happened to be passing by, and that was why he was so severely punished. To put it more bluntly, the cadet said that the unfortunate boy had died under the rod, and as at that time such a thing was not looked on as impossible, this too was believed, and the cadet himself became a new apparition. After this cadet's downfall, the bedroom that was the cause of all the terror in the engineer's castle was thrown open and put to such a use as to destroy its uncanny reputation. But nevertheless, the tradition of the ghost lived on for a long time. The cadets continued to believe that their castle was haunted by a ghost that appeared at night. This was the general conviction held equally by young and old cadets, with the difference, however, that the younger ones believed blindly in the apparition, while the elder ones sometimes personally arranged its appearance. This didn't prevent those responsible for the apparition from being afraid of it. In the same way, false makers of miracles, who produce the miracles themselves, bow down before them and believe in their reality. The young cadets didn't know the whole story, about which it was strongly forbidden to speak after the event of the cruel corporal punishment. But among elder cadets, there were some who had been either whipped or flogged and knew the whole secret of the apparition. This gave the elders great prestige, which they enjoyed until the years 1859 or 1860, when four of them went through a very trying ordeal, which I shall relate from the story of one of the participants in the misplaced joke at the coffin.